Hello friends, in this video let us discuss about the three winding transformer. So I hope that most of you have studied about the two winding transformer. Now coming to the three winding transformer, so the transformers may be built from a third winding, which is known as a tertiary winding, in addition to the normal primary winding and secondary winding. So such transformers with primary winding, secondary winding and tertiary winding is referred to as a three winding transformer. So the three winding are nothing but one is primary winding, primary, secondary, and the other one is the tertiary. Now you might get a doubt why we are employing this tertiary winding when we already have a two winding transformer. So there are several advantages of this tertiary winding, and we shall discuss those advantages. And along with the advantages, we shall discuss the operating principle, construction and the equivalent circuit of the three winding transformer. So first, if we talk about the purpose of employing this tertiary winding, so one purpose for employing this tertiary winding is, so the tertiary winding can serve to supply, they can use to supply the substation auxiliaries. So you might have visited the substation where the tertiary winding serves to supply the substation auxiliaries at a voltage which is different from the primary voltage and the secondary voltage. So in order to supply the substation auxiliaries, the auxiliaries may be fan, tube lights, like that. So in order to supply the substation auxiliaries at a voltage which is different than the primary voltage and the secondary voltage, so this is one purpose. And the second purpose is to supply phase compensating devices such as condensers, which will operate at a voltage different from the primary voltage and the secondary voltage, which is different from the primary voltage and secondary voltage. So in practically all extensive high voltage system, regulation of voltage at certain points is provided by the synchronous condensers. So your synchronous motor, when it is operating under the over excitation, then it can be referred to as the synchronous condensers. So in all extensive high voltage systems, regulation of voltage at certain points can be provided by the synchronous condensers, and these synchronous condensers can be connected to the high voltage system through the transformers. So if I say here is a high voltage system, so through the transformers these synchronous condensers are connected to the high voltage system, and from economical consideration this transformer is nothing but it employs the tertiary winding. So through the tertiary winding you can connect your synchronous condensers to the high voltage system for the regulation of voltage at certain points. So this is the second purpose. And the third purpose is, if you are having a three supply systems which are operating at different voltages, so when you have such three different supply systems operating at different voltages, you can interconnect those supply systems operating at different voltages. Interconnect different supply systems operating at different voltages. And the fourth advantage is to load your split winding generators. So when the winding is split, it is known as a split winding. So to load your split winding generators, the tertiary winding might be used. And for the fifth purpose of this tertiary winding is to measure voltage of a high voltage testing transformer. High voltage testing transformer, because the tertiary winding can be used as a voltage coil to measure the voltage of a high voltage testing transformer. And the sixth purpose is in a star connected transformers. So let me say I am having a transformer which is star connected. So in the star cell currented transformer, to allow for sufficient earth fault current to flow, for operation of protective equipment. So now we require the operation of protective equipments, and these protective equipment can be operated by some earth fault current, and this protective equipment will suppress your harmonic voltages and they limits your unbalanced voltages. So they will suppress your harmonics and they limit your unbalanced voltages when the main load is unsymmetrical. So this is a very great advantage of having a tertiary winding. And your tertiary winding can also be referred as a auxiliary winding when this tertiary winding is employed for feeding an additional load, additional small load at a different voltage than the primary voltage and the secondary voltage. And this tertiary winding can also be called as a stabilizing winding when it is used or when it is employed to limit the short circuit current in the star-star connected transformer. So normally the tertiary windings are the delta connected windings. They are the delta connected windings, and whenever some short circuit or fault occur on the primary and the secondary sides, any considerable unbalance occurring in the phase voltages or any unbalance produced in the phase voltages can be compensated by the circulating currents flowing in a closed delta. So this is the tertiary winding is nothing but a closed delta. So any unbalance produced in the phase voltages due to the faults or the short circuits occurring in the primary or secondary sides can be compensated by the circulating currents flowing in the closed delta, and the reactance of these windings must be large enough to limit the circulating currents and also to ensure the heating capacity of these windings. So these are the advantages of having your tertiary winding. Now let us discuss about the operating principle of your three winding transformer. So the operating principle of the three winding transformer is similar to the two winding transformer. So in a two winding transformer, we say when an alternating current is flows through the primary winding, then that primary winding will produce an alternating flux, and that flux flows through the core and it links with the secondary winding, and an EMF will be induced in that winding. And if a load is connected to the secondary winding, then the current starts flowing, and there will be a demagnetizing effect of that secondary current, and for to compensate the demagnetizing effect, the primary current draws some additional current so that the flux, the MMF will be maintained constant. So similarly, in a three winding transformer, if I say this is one winding and this will be the other winding, and let me say this will be the other, this is a rough diagram I am drawing. This is, I am considering primary winding, this is the secondary, and this is the tertiary. So here your primary winding will act as a magnetizing winding, and the current flowing the primary winding will produce the main magnetizing current, or that is the main magnetizing flux. So the current flowing in the primary winding will produce the main magnetic flux, and this flux links with the secondary winding as well as the tertiary winding, and the EMF will be induced in those winding in proportion to the number of turns on those winding. So we know that EMF will be equal to minus N into d phi by dt. So in proportion to the number of turns, an EMF will be induced in the secondary and tertiary winding. And now the role of demagnetizing effect comes, and the demagnetizing effect of these currents can be determined by the geometric sum of the magnetizing forces of the secondary winding as well as tertiary winding. So the demagnetizing effect of the currents I2 and I3 will be determined by the magnetizing force, that is a geometric sum of the magnetizing force of the secondary and the tertiary winding. So the magnetizing force will be, if I say N2 is the number of turns in the secondary winding and N3 is the number of turns in the tertiary winding, so N2 I2 will be magnetizing force in the secondary winding and N3 I3 will be the magnetizing force of the tertiary winding. And now the magnetizing force of the primary winding must balance the combined magnetizing forces of this secondary circuit, that is the secondary winding and the tertiary winding, as well as it must have a magnetizing component. So if we now talk about the MMF, of this three winding transformer, so basically if I say N1 is the number of turns here and I am having current I1, so your N1 I1 will be equal to minus N2 I2 minus N3 I3 plus I0 into N1. So where I0 into N1 is your magnetizing component to produce the main magnetic flux, and this minus sign here and here just depicts that they are opposing the main magnetic flux. So as they are opposing the main magnetic flux, I have represented them with the minus sign. Elsewise you can write simply N1 I1 will be equal to N2 I2 plus N3 I3 plus I0 into N1. So you can write in this fashion also according to your wish. Now from here you can see that I1 will be equal to minus N2 I2 upon I1, that is N1, minus N3 I3 upon N1 plus I0 N1 upon N1. So this gets cancelled. We are left with only this current, the magnetizing component, which is I0. So from here you can write your I1 will be just equal to I2 dash. So I am representing I2 dash as minus N2 upon N1 into I2 plus I3 dash, which is nothing but minus N3 upon N1 into I3 plus I0. Now this current equation shows you that there will be a simultaneous transfer of electrical energy to both the secondary circuits, that is the secondary winding and the tertiary winding. So the energy will transfer at the same time to both the windings, and you need not confuse that first it will energize the secondary winding or first it will energize the tertiary winding. Simultaneously electrical energy transfer takes place, and at this juncture it is worth to remember that it is to be noted that both the phases, that is both the secondary and the tertiary winding, will not be loaded fully at the same time. It is highly improbable. It is highly, or you can say highly improbable or less probable. It is very less probable. The probability is very less that both the secondary winding and the tertiary winding will be fully loaded at the same time. And it is also highly improbable that the secondary, that the currents I2 dash and I3 dash will be in phase at the same time when they are fully loaded. So for this reason, the primary winding of the three winding transformer is usually designed for a smaller, it is usually designed for a smaller or lower load compared to the sum of rated powers of the secondary and the tertiary windings. So this is all about the operating principle. Now let us talk about the construction. So we have said that a three winding transformer consists of three sets of winding where one winding is the primary and the other one is the secondary and other one is the tertiary. So it consists of three sets of winding, and the three winding transformer may be either a single three phase unit, it may be a single three phase unit, or it may be a single phase units connected in three phase bank. So either of them can be your three winding transformer, and it consists of three sets of winding, and you can see that the three sets of winding will operate at different voltages. And as they operate at different voltages, that is normally your primary winding is designed for the higher voltage and the secondary will be designed for the medium voltage, or the tertiary will be designed for the lower voltage. So the three windings will operate at three different voltages, and I'll name them as high voltage winding, medium voltage winding and the low voltage winding. And usually these three winding transformers have a higher KVA rating. They usually have a higher KVA rating, and these three windings will operate at three different voltages. Now if we talk about the arrangements of these windings, so generally there are two possible alternatives for arrangement of this winding starting from the core outwards. So if I say I'm having a core, so this is your core of the transformer, then you can have the two possible arrangements of this winding. So here let me say initially I'm having one winding, let me say this is my low voltage winding. So this is your low voltage winding, and again you are having the other winding, which is nothing but the medium voltage winding, and again you are having your other voltage, which is nothing but the high voltage winding. So this can be one possible arrangement where this is low voltage, this is medium voltage and this is high voltage. Now the other possible arrangement of the winding is, again let me say this is your core, this is the core of the transformer, and again you are having the three windings, but this time the combination changes, but in both cases you will have the second, that is a high voltage winding far from the core. So again this will be your medium voltage and this will be your low voltage and this will be your high voltage. So this will be your low voltage and this will be your high voltage. So in both cases you will see the high voltage winding will be outside in both cases because of insulation consideration. So because of insulation considerations, your higher voltage when placed near to the core, it will require higher insulation. So by extending far from the core or by considering the insulation, we are keeping this high voltage winding far from the core out, starting from outwards. And in both the cases you can see the LV voltage and the MV voltage, that is LV and MV, are kept adjacent to each other, and this pair is placed nearer to the core and they are kept adjacent to each other, so that the leakage reactance, there is a leakage reactance of the pair can be reduced, of the pair, these two windings, or you can say the leakage reactance in between these pair of windings can be reduced, so that there is a reason they are kept nearer to each other and nearer to the core, or you can say adjacent to each other and nearer to the core. Now if we talk about the rating of the transformer, so normally in the two winding transformer, in your two winding transformer, the rating of the primary and the secondary winding will be same. So the primary winding and the secondary winding will have the same KVA rating in the two winding transformer, and that KVA rating will be the rating of that transformer. So KVA rating of the primary winding and the secondary winding will be same, and that KVA rating is nothing but the KVA rating of the two winding transformer. But in three winding transformer the case changes, it is not the same case. In three winding transformer the three winding may have different KVA ratings, and the rating of the three winding transformer will be equal to the largest KVA rating of any of the transformer. It will be equal to the largest KVA rating of any of the transformer. So this is the most important thing you have to remember compared to the two winding transformer. Now if you talk about the rating of the tertiary winding, so what should be the rating of the tertiary winding? So the rating of tertiary winding depends on the intended application. It depends on the application you choose for your tertiary winding. So now if you choose your tertiary winding for supplying an additional load, then the design and the calculation will be on the same basis as for the primary and the secondary winding. So when it is for supplying some additional load, additional small load, then it will have the same design and the calculation as per your primary and the secondary winding. Now you may say the tertiary winding is used for balancing the load as well as for limiting the short circuit current, then the rating of the tertiary winding will depend on the heat capacity of the winding. So because during short circuit the currents will flow only for short period of time, and that short circuit current will that short circuit current will be having a higher value, and the heat capacity of these tertiary winding must bear that high short circuit current for a short period of time. That means based on the heat capacity the rating is determined here, and for when it is supplying some additional small load, then the design and the calculation will be same basis as per the primary and the secondary winding. But in practice, this is actually what we say in theory, but in practice normally the cross section of the wire will be determined by the fault considerations. So it will be determined by the fault considerations irrespective of what the application you are going to use your tertiary winding. So remember this, though in theory they say it depends on the intended application, because in the short circuit currents because while limiting the short circuit current, the current only flows for a short amount of time, but large amount of current will flow for that short amount of time. So depending on the heat capacity, the rating of the tertiary winding is decided. So, but this is a selling theory, but when you consider in practice, so depending on the fault considerations, the cross section of the wire will be determined. So this is the construction of the transformer. Now we will talk about the equivalent circuit. So here the equivalent circuit for a three winding transformer can be drawn with each winding represented by its own resistance and leakage reactance. That is each winding, that is the primary winding and the secondary winding and the tertiary winding, can be drawn with each, that is the equivalent circuit of a three winding transformer can be drawn with each winding represented by its own resistance and leakage reactance. So let me draw the equivalent circuit for this. First, for the primary winding, its own resistance and leakage reactance, and from here I'm having the secondary, its own resistance again and leakage reactance, and again I am having the tertiary, its resistance and leakage reactance. So this will be the equivalent circuit of the three winding transformer, where this is your Z1 and this is Z2 and Z3, where 1, 2 and 3 subscripts represent that the 1 is for primary winding, 2 is for the secondary winding and 3 is for the tertiary winding. And if I draw the neutral one, so, and earlier we have said that the three windings will operate at three different voltages. So here you can see this is your voltage V3, this is your voltage V2, and this will be the voltage V1. And if I say the terminals, this is 1, this is 2 and this is 3, the three terminals are connected to three external circuits. So here you are having the supply, here you are having the supply, and these two terminals, that is the terminal 2 and terminal 3, can be connected to the load. So this is having a three terminals, one is for that is three terminals with three external circuits. So here these impedances, which are all referred to a common base, can be found out by conducting three short circuit tests. So by conducting three short circuit tests, we can determine the impedances of this equivalent circuit, that is Z1, Z2 and Z3. Now we do not know what is Z1, Z2, Z3. So by conducting three short circuit tests, from that data we can determine what is the impedance Z1, Z2 and Z3. So when all are referred to the common base, remember this point. Now here you should also note that the load division on this secondary winding and the tertiary winding is not fixed, but it is arbitrary. So remember that the arbitrary load division takes place, arbitrary load division takes place on the secondary and the tertiary winding. Now, by connecting three short circuit tests, we shall determine the impedances Z1, Z2 and Z3. So, first what we do is the short circuit impedance of winding 1 and 2 with the third winding open. So, we have opened this third winding and we have short circuited this winding 1 and 2. So, when you short circuit the winding 1 and 2, your Z12 will be equal to Z1 plus Z2. This is winding 1 and 2 short circuited with third open. So, this is one short circuit test. This is one short circuit test, and the second short circuit test is the short circuit impedance of the winding 1 and 3 with winding 2 open. So, when you open the second winding, the short circuit impedance will be Z13 will be equal to Z1 plus Z3. And now, conducting the third short circuit test, now the short circuit impedance of the winding 2 and 3 with the winding 1 open. So, when you open the winding 1, you will get the short circuit impedance of winding 2 and 3. That will be nothing but Z2 plus Z3. Now, you have three equations. This is 1 and this is 2 and this is 3. Now, you have three equations and three unknowns. So, by solving these three equations, you will get what is Z1, Z2 and Z3. So, your Z1 will be equal to half of Z12 plus Z21 minus Z23. This will be your Z1, and all these impedances are referred to the common base, and your Z2 will be again half of Z21 plus Z23 minus Z31, and your Z3 will be equal to half of Z31 plus Z32 minus Z21 or 12, where Z12 will be equal to Z21 or Z21 will be equal to Z1. So here, how to remember this? What you do is, your Z1, where I am having here 1, and when you subtract a impedance, in that there should not be 1. So when you are having 1, here it should be 2 and 3, and when you are having 2, here it should be 3 and 1. That is, if I have 2 here, then you have to subtract the term which is other than 2, and see here you are having 3, and again here you are having 2, 1. That means when you are finding 3, then you have to subtract the term which is not having 3. So this is how you remember. So by solving these three equations, you can easily get this impedances of this equivalent circuit. And the other thing is your core losses as well as the magnetizing impedances and the turns ratio, all this can be determined by performing the open circuit test on any of the three windings. So by performing the open circuit test on any of the three windings, you can determine all these quantities. So this is all about the three winding transformer, and in our next video we shall discuss how the stabilization can be done by using tertiary winding. So this is all for today about the three winding transformer. I hope you understood well. Please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.